Hi guys, welcome on my channel Koszywiwdzianem. Today I'm going to show you this interesting doily project. This doily has 16 inches in diameter. For my project I am using crochet hook size 1.5 millimeters and the thread in size 10. This doily has 16 rands, so we can make this project even in one day. So let's get started. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot. Then chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Slip stitch into our first chain stitch to form a ring. And we are going to start our first round. Chain of 3. As a first double crochet. Now into the ring we are going to work another 23 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then we need to work our double crochets to the end, so in total we should have 24 and at the end we are going to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of the first double crochet. Second round we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then one double crochet in next two stitches. 1 and 2. Now chain 3, then one double crochet in next three double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 3 and then again one double crochet in next three double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain 3. And from now we are going to repeat our pattern all the way around. So we should have 8 groups of 3 double crochets and 8 chain 3 spaces. After our last group we are going to work slip stitch in third chain stitch. Now we are going to start third round and we need to work slip stitch in next 2 double crochets, then slip stitch in chain 3 space. Now chain of 3. Then into the same chain space we are going to work 2 double crochets, chain 3 and 2 and another 3 double crochets. So we've got some kind of shell, 3 double crochets, chain 3 and 3 double crochets. After our last one we need to work chain of 6, 4, 5 and 6, then into the next chain space again 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3, chain of 3 and then 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3, chain of 6, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, then in next chain space another shell. So this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. In each chain 3 space we need to work 3 double crochets, then chain 3 and another group of 3 double crochets and then chain of 6 after each shell. So you should have 8 shells and 8 chain 6 spaces. At the end, after the last chain space, we have to work slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start round number 4 by making slip stitch in next 2 double crochets and slip stitch in chain 3 space. Now chain of 3 as a double crochet and into our chain 3 space, so into the center of our shell, we are going to work shell again. So another 2 double crochets, chain 3 and then 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Now chain of 5, so one less than in our previous round, and then we need to go to the next shell. Chain 6 we are going to skip. Another shell, 3 double crochets in center of shell from the previous round. Chain 3 and 3 double crochets. Chain of 5, then shell in next shell, 3 double crochets, chain 3 and 3 double crochets. Chain of 5. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around, so we should have 8 shells again, and this time 8 chain 5 spaces. Now we are going to start round number 5, so again we need to work slip stitch in next 2 double crochets, then slip stitch in chain 3. Now chain of 3 as a double crochet, 2 double crochets in the same chain space, chain of 3 and 3 more double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Now chain 3, then we are going to work single crochet but underneath our chain 6 space from third round. So we are going to put our 2 chain spaces on our hook and then work single crochet and then chain of 3, so we've got spider stitch. Now 3 double crochets in next chain 3 space, 1, 2 and 3, chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. So again we've got shell in each shell from our previous round, but now we are going to repeat our pattern, chain 3, single crochet in our chain 6 space from round number 3, chain 3 and then another shell in next shell, 3 double crochets, chain 3 and 3 double crochets. So this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 6 and we need to work slip stitch in next 2 double crochets, then slip stitch in next 2 chain stitches, slip stitch in chain space, chain 1 and single crochet. So we've done single crochet in the center of our first shell, now chain of 9, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Single crochet into the single crochet from our previous round, then chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Single crochet in chain 3 space, chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, single crochet into the single crochet, chain 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, single crochet into the single into the chain into our shell. So this is our actually whole pattern. One time we are going to work single crochet in shell, then chain 9, then into the single crochet, then again chain of 9, single crochet into the center of the shell, then chain 9 and single crochet into the single crochet. So now we need to repeat this pattern all the way around. After the last chain 9 space we are going to work slip stitch in first single crochet. Round number 7, we are going to start by making slip stitch in our first chain space, now chain 3 as a first double crochet, then into the chain space we are going to work 9 double crochets, 1, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. So we should have 10 double crochets in our first chain 9 space, and now we are going to repeat, so 10 double crochets in each chain space all the way around. 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So this this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around. After our last double crochet, we need to work slip stitch into the first one. Round number 8, we are going to start by making chain of 4 as a first treble crochet. Then into the next double crochet from our previous round, we have to work treble crochet again. Chain of 9, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then we are going directly to the last double crochet of our first group and we are going to work treble crochet again. So into the first one, into the second, then chain of 9 and into the last one. And now we are going to repeat. So we need to work one treble crochet into the first one and into the second. 1 and 2. Chain of 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, and then we are going to the last double crochet of the same group, 1 treble crochet. Then again, 1 treble crochet into the first one and into the second, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, and then treble crochet into the last. So by working this way, we've got groups of 3 treble crochets and then chain 9 spaces. So this is mean that at the end of our round we are going to work 1 treble crochet in our last double crochet and then slip stitch into the 4th chain stitch of our first treble crochet. Round number 9, we are going to start by making slip stitch in our third treble crochet, but second from the beginning. Then we need to work slip stitch into the next 3 chain stitches. Slip stitch into the chain space and now chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Into the same chain space we need to work 2 more double crochets. Then chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. So again, we are going to work with shells. Now, chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then into the next chain space, we are going to work another shell. 3 double crochets. Chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. Chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then into the next chain space we are going to work another shell. And basically this is our whole pattern. Shell in each chain 9 space from the previous round. And then chain of 9 again. So now, after our last chain space, we need to work slip stitch into the first double crochet. Round number 10, we are going to start by making slip stitch in next 2 double crochets. then slip stitch in our chain 3 space. So we are in the center of our shell and we are going to start with chain 3 as a double crochet, then another 2 double crochets, chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. So we've got shell in the center of our shell. In our previous round we've done chain of 9, now we are going to make chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then we need to go to the next shell and we have to repeat. So 3 double crochets, chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then we have to go to the next shell. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. In each shell we are going to work shell and then chain of 7. So at the end, after our last chain space, we have to work slip stitch in first double crochet. Round number 11. We are going to start by making slip stitch in next 2 double crochets, then slip stitch in chain space. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet and now we are going to work another shell. So 2 double crochets, chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then into the next shell we have to work shell again. 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 3 and another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So this pattern is exactly the same as we've done in our last one round. We've got shell in each shell and then chain 7 space. Round number 12, we are going to start by making again slip stitch in next 2 double crochets and slip stitch in chain 3. So we are going to start first shell, chain of 3 as a double crochet, then 2 double crochets in chain 3 space, chain of 3 and another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now we need to insert our crochet hook under our chain 9 space. So we should have 3 chain spaces from our last 3 runs on our hook and then we are going to work single crochet. So we've got spider stitch again. Chain of 5 and now we are going to the next shell, then we have to work another shell. 3 double crochets, chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then again we need to insert our crochet hook under our chain 9 space, then we are going to work single crochet on our all 3 chain spaces. Chain of 5, then shell in next shell. 3 double crochets, chain 3 and another 3 double crochets. So this pattern now again we are going to repeat all the way around. So we are going to have shell in each shell and then chain 5 single crochet on our all 3 chain spaces from the last 3 runs and then another chain of 5. So now we need to continue this pattern all the way around. Round number 13. We are going to start by making a slip stitch in next 2 chain stitches. Then slip stitch in our first chain stitch and slip stitch into the chain space. Chain 1 and single crochet. And in exactly the same way as we've done it before, now we are going to start with chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Single crochet into the single crochet. Then chain of 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Single crochet into the next shell, chain of 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, single crochet into the next single crochet, chain of 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, then single crochet into the next shell. So all the way around we are going to work chain of 9 spaces, then single crochet into the shell or single crochet into the single crochets. Now we are going to start round number 14 by making slip stitch in our first chain space, chain of 3 as a double crochet, then we are going to work another 11 double crochets in the same chain space. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. So now we've got a group of 12 double crochets in our chain 9 space, and after our last double crochet now we are going to work chain of 32. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 30, 1 and 2. So 32 chain stitches, and then after our last chain stitch we are going directly to the next chain space and we are going to work another 12 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So after next group of 12 double crochets, we are going to repeat our chain 32. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1 and 2. Then we are going to the next chain 9 space and we have to work another group of 12 double crochets and then again chain 32. So after each group we are going to work chain of 32 and then 12 double crochets. So now this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around, and at the end after our last chain space slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start round 15, but at the end of our round 14, after the last chain 32 space, we are going to work slip stitch in first double crochet, then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So we are going to join our thread directly into chain space. So it's a little bit easier than working slip stitch in each double crochet and then slip stitch in some chain stitches. So we are going to join into our chain 30 to space. So not exactly from the beginning, just leave few chain stitches on the bottom, and now chain of three as a first double crochet. Into the same chain space we are going to work another 25 double crochets. 25. So we should have 26 double crochets in total. So then we can slip our double crochets a little bit on the another side of our chain space, and this we can do exactly at the end. And now we are going directly to the next chain 32 space, and we have to work another 26 double crochets, and this is actually our whole pattern for this round. 26 double crochets in any chain 32 space. So just continue all the way around. At the end, after our last group of 26 double crochets, we need to work slip stitch into the first one, and I will go back at the beginning of our last one around, round number 16. Now we are going to start our last one around, round number 16. So after slip stitch in our first double crochet, now we need to work slip stitch in next. 1, 2, 3, and 4. In next 4 stitches. So we are going to start from the 5th double crochet. Now chain 1 and single crochet in our double crochet. Chain 3, single crochet in next double crochet. Chain 3, then single crochet in next double crochet. Chain 3, single crochet in next. Chain 3, single crochet in next one. Chain 3, then single crochet in next. And we are going to repeat this pattern by working chain of 3 and single crochet in each double crochet until our last 4 in this group. So we are going to skip our first 4 double crochets and the last as well. So this is mean that we should have 18 single crochets and 17 chain 3 spaces per motif. So chain 3, single crochet into the double crochet. So I'm going to make sure how many double crochets I've got left. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got 2 more to do. And now I'm going to skip my last 4 and the first 4 in the next group. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now we need to work single crochet into the 5th, and we are going to continue our work. Chain of 3 and single crochet in next double crochet, apart from our last 4. So each time on each motif you should have a 18 single crochets and 17 chain 3 spaces. And this pattern now we are going to continue all the way around. After our last single crochet into the fifth double crochet from the end, we need to work slip stitch in first single crochet, then we can fasten off and cut the yarn, so our project will be done. So thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. I hope you like this type of project. Just let me in the comment section below what do you think about this doily, and see you in the next tutorial. Have a nice day.